Hey everybody, it's Jeff Lafferty. And what's this one? Number 6. Vlog number 6. I need like a cool title for this thing. You know, maybe some music at the beginning. I don't know about that. But how's it going, everybody? Thanks for coming back. Doing this Black Widow drawing. Scarlett Johansson. And I want to make a kind of series of the Avengers stuff. So I want to do Black Widow, Hulk, Iron Man, and Captain America. So this is kind of what I'm thinking maybe for her. I don't know. I think I'm going to do a few sketches of her and just pick the best one, the one I like the best. But just kind of at that stage where I'm kind of throwing in the black, I already kind of drew it lighter with this pencil, just initial sketch. Then I kind of come back and darken it up a little more with my blacks, and then come in with some black paint and all that. Just the same old process as I always do. But I finished up. Let me show it to you. Oh, everything's falling down. This Hulk piece took me 2 days, basically. More like a day and a half, but yesterday was a pretty long day. But man, I love the way it came out. I think it just rocks. And it's already on eBay. It's already got bids. And I'm really happy with this one. This one, I kind of tried to, I mean, I've been trying to kind of be more, I don't want to say loose, but just, like when I draw these kind of pieces, I'm already going to launch right into it, but when I draw these kind of pieces, I notice I'm very much, you know, I just sit down and I just draw. I don't need to really like turn on some music or, you know, I don't have kind of any reservations in a way when I'm drawing. And for some reason, like when I paint, it's almost like I think in my mind I have this mental thing of like, oh, well, painting is hard, so that's going to take a while, you know. But like with the drawing, it's like I always, you know, finish a drawing like in a day. I never really even think, oh, it's going to take longer than that to do it. And I think it's just like a mental kind of block that I'm kind of trying to not get over, but just, you know, just go through those pieces like with passion and stuff like I do my drawings. And not let them become like overwhelming and get on parts of like, you know, I don't know, like out here or something and be like, oh, this is going to take forever. Like, because it's not that important, you know. I mean, that's actually kind of a little bit more important, but like over here and stuff. It's just, it's not as, you know what I mean? It should be loose out there. I mean, the faces should be nice and perfect and, you know, or whatever the focal point is, but then it's like, you know, when you get out on some of this other stuff, it should be more artistic, you know. I mean, I want them to look like a drawing. I don't want them to just look like a photo. Or, you know, kind of what's the point? And I, actually, on this one, too, this is the first time it's ever happened to me. This board actually kind of tried to warp on me a little. Now it's completely flat again, but I actually painted some gesso on the back to pull it back the other way. But, not quite sure why that happened. I mean, this was an older piece of board that I've just had sitting around. It's kind of funny, but when I went up to Home Depot to get more MDF, they were out for some reason. So I didn't grab it last week, and I just kind of been using all my spare cut pieces that I've had laying around. And so this one was probably laying around for a while. It might have got wet on the back or something, and that had why it had a little tendency to warp or something. But I've also been kind of wondering, like, the first couple ones of these that I did, like these kind of like longer square movie scene type pieces, I actually varnished with like an acrylic varnish, painted it on, so it's kind of like a heavy layer. And I thought it looked pretty decent, and that's the way I used to do all my stuff, all of my older sketch cards and stuff, they're all varnished. But then, I don't know, you know, I've been kind of just like liking the look that they have right now, you know, but there's some color pencil. I mean, it's kind of a delicate surface still. So I've kind of been experimenting around. I bought some fixative and I sprayed the the Robin Hood piece. Actually, I'll go get it and show you guys. Looks like, hang on a sec. Okay, here's that Robin Hood piece. It's getting packaged up, going out today. I held it back just because I wanted to figure out what I was going to put on it. But you can see I sprayed a little bit of, right there you can see just a, I mean it's way shinier in the camera than it is actually in real life. But you can see there's a little bit of a sheen on it. But I sprayed it with a matte finish, fixative. And not even a final fix. I mean, this is the fixative that you're supposed to be able to kind of work on again. But I think I like this because it makes it a little more consistent. It doesn't completely make it like a, you know, like a surface. Like it's not a varnish. And I don't know. I mean, I used to even varnish my drawings, and people used to hate that. And now I don't even put anything on my drawings. But you know, just trying to figure out what kind of surface or what kind of stuff to put on the pieces. And I think I do like this. I've been looking at this all morning, just kind of trying to figure out if this is what I want to do on all of them. This is a cool piece. I think the client's gonna just love it when he gets it. But let's see what's going on. I found actually a really neat video. Dave Gaskin put up a new video on his channel. He's had videos on his channel. He's a guy. I'll put a link in the show notes. He's a really good artist. And he put up a new video, and it's kind of, you know, like a lot like the ones I'm doing now. And it's just super cool because it's just him kind of sitting around talking and drawing. And his old videos were like the kind of the classic time lapse kind of thing. I hope he really, I mean, I really hope he kind of keeps going with these because it's kind of, you know, it's like the same kind of, you know, almost, I don't know what you'd call like my, you know, my new videos, like vlog type things or almost like a podcast type thing. And I think it's just cool because I didn't get to listen to the whole thing because I looked at it and it was up this morning, and I listened to part of it, and then I was like, I gotta start drawing on this thing or I'm not gonna get the video done before Tanya and them come back. And let's see, it kind of goes that way. Got some hair. And anyway, I'm gonna listen to the rest of it when I get done when I get done actually recording this video. And but everybody should go check it out because he is a super good artist, and he's actually a guy who I think that could really pull something like that off, because for a while there I know he was doing I think I found him on DeviantArt a while ago, or maybe he just found me, I'm not sure. But let's see, it goes down. But he was doing like a, he had like kind of like one of those, you know, I'm going to do a sketch card a day kind of challenges going for himself, which is, yeah, that's pretty tough, especially when you got a part-time job. But he does kind of like gray tone drawings like this, and he was pulling it off there for a while. I remember reading a blog post where he was like, maybe he fell off. And was like, I can't do it no more. But then I saw a bunch more of them later, so I don't know if he kind of caught himself back up and started again or what. But anyway, yeah, go check that video out. And like, I don't know if Dave's listening, but yeah, those are awesome, dude. Keep going with those. I think those are great. And it's nice to have, you know, I wish a lot of people would do it really, because it's just, I mean, this is the kind of stuff I like to listen to. I'm always. Look, hang on a sec. Okay. It's funny, it's, well anyway, like what I was saying, this is just, that's the kind of stuff I like to listen to. But I'm all kind of messed up today because when I first set myself up to, you know, draw this and start recording, like dog came in here and she like went under my table like she always does and got tangled up in my airbrush hose, and my airbrush hose sits, or my airbrush always kind of just sits on the glass of water with the paintbrushes in it and stuff. So she knocked over my glass of water on the floor. And then she, you know, which was like a big mess. And it's like right next to where I paint. So it's kind of like a big wet spot on the floor. And I have a fan drying it out right now. But every now and then I'll move my foot over and I'll get my sock wet. So it kind of sucks. Also, I'm kind of like painting way over. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm like way over on my table, further than what I usually am. Let's see, what was I going to talk about today? Well, you know, actually, I had a couple questions on my site. One of them was, what kind of music I listen to. And that was from a question on Patreon from another guy who's like, let me sharpen my pencil. Really good artist, goes by the name of Ambro, I think. And I'll put his link in the show notes too. And he does like long speed paint type videos also on YouTube. I guess we're all kind of, you know, we make these videos and, you know, watch these videos, and we're all kind of finding each other on YouTube, which is kind of cool. But anyway, he asked me like what kind of music I listen to, like when I paint. I think maybe John Riggle asked me that too. And it's just like all over the place. You know what I mean? It's, I don't know. A lot of times I listen to podcasts. I mean, I have like just a big old list of podcasts that I listen to. Like if you go into this, in my website on jefflafferty.net now, I need to tell you guys that too. It's no longer jefflafferty.com. I lost that domain because I was just dumb about it. And so I went and bought jefflafferty.net. So that takes you to my site if you're wanting to get there. But anyway, if you go there and you go into the, you know, hit the links button, I got a link with, to, you know, all my favorite stuff. That's kind of why I did that too. You know, I used to have such a hard time keeping track of stuff, and so finally I was just like, I'm gonna put everything I like on my site in a feed so that, you know, when it updates, I know to go look at it, you know, because I'm not a guy who could, I don't know, I still honestly can't figure out iTunes. You know, and I just miss stuff, you know, and it just drives me crazy when I can't get something in some sort of feed or like an email alert or something that tells me that people are putting stuff up, because I just forget. And you know, there's a couple podcasts I listen to where they're like that, where they're just super hard to keep track of, and I'm always missing them. But I listen to like a ton of podcasts, and I also listen to music. What I do is I kind of like, as the day goes on, I'll get tired of podcasts and I'll just turn them off. And then, you know, a lot of times I'll hit music, and sometimes if I'm really, you know, just needing to get fired up, I'll just, you know, write to the music. And sometimes I'll put a movie on and listen to it. And that always has to be like something that doesn't take my attention. It's got to be, let's see. Because if it starts making me kind of look over at the computer and watch it, then it just doesn't work. So I like watch one of my favorite movies. I got a bunch of them downloaded on my computer, so I'll put on, you know, I don't know, the old Clash of the Titans or something. You know, I was watching, or listening to, one of my favorite movies last night, Streets of Fire, which I want to do some art from Streets of Fire. I don't know if anybody even knows about that movie anymore, but it's a really good one. And I also, you know, it's funny, I've been downloading some stuff, like some like older movies that just, you know, I've been like, what are my favorite movies? And just, you know, a lot of them are probably not stuff that anybody's wanting to buy stuff from, but maybe though. And you know, like I got the Dark Crystal the other night, and just a lot of that, you know, 70s kind of kind of animation, puppetry, that kind of stuff. The Frazetta movie, Fire and Ice, and the Lord of the Rings movie that Bakshi did, which everybody kind of bags on now, but I still really like that movie. I saw that in the theaters when I was a kid, and you know, I actually really like, especially like when there's parts of it that are animated so just well, you know, so beautifully, that I don't know. I wish in a way he'd have done more of them, but the battle scenes in that movie, you know, it's like you never have enough money, I'm sure, when you're doing movies, and I'm sure that was his problem, but like the battle scenes in that movie are just, they're so, they did some weird kind of rotoscope type technique, and not even like a rotoscope where you trace over the drawing or something, it's like one where they, I think they were just kind of changing the opacity or whatever, and kind of burning out the images, and so it's like you could, it's almost like just filmed footage that you're watching, and not very good film footage, you know. But yeah, but anyway, I also kind of want to do some art from like the Labyrinth and all that Jim Henson stuff, you know. Remember he did like a TV show, the Storyteller, which nobody remembers that, you know, but that was a really cool. I was also watching Legend, the Ridley Scott movie with Tom Cruise and the other girl. And that's just an awesome movie, you know what I mean? It's just like, I mean, I know people probably don't like it, but I love that movie. I think that movie is really cool. And some awesome imagery, you know, with like the unicorns running around and stuff. I mean, just beautiful. Anyway, like I was trying to answer like what kind of music I listen to. And so I thought I'd just put all that in there. I do a lot, I listen to a lot of that kind of stuff. But yeah, when I listen to music, it's, I don't know, it's, I mean, I've never been a guy who's been into music. I've been, like last year I worked with this guy, John. He's like just a music nut. And, he kind of turned me on to a lot of like good music that that I just didn't really know about. But the thing is, I just still don't even have that much of a passion for it because you know, it's like it's kind of fun to listen to like when he would bring his stuff and play it. But you know, as far as finding it and listening to it, it's just it's like I have like kind of like old standbys, which is like a bunch of 80s rock kind of stuff, you know, like Journey and stuff. And like inevitably when I just hit my player, it's like I just fire that up and listen to, you know, some Pat Benatar and stuff and just let it go through all of them randomly, and I've listened to like that stuff like forever. And I also have like a ton of soundtracks because for a while there I was kind of like cutting in the actual movie music, like when I would do like that Conan piece, I like got the Conan soundtrack and cut that in, so that all that stuff was in my music file. So I just become like a real fan of that now, and I do kind of, you know, I really like, you know, like the you know, like the Conan soundtrack, of course. But then there's like some others that are just really beautiful, and one of them that I just love is like the Last of the Mohicans soundtrack. I mean, that's just some awesome music. And you know, just like the new stuff too, the Avengers. I have like the Inception soundtrack. I don't even know why I got that one, but that one's in there. Very like moody, very cool kind of stuff. So I don't know, it just depends like what day it is and what I'm thinking, what I'm doing. That's the kind of music I listen to. The other question I got was Travis Kakos, who's another awesome artist. I guess artists watch my stuff because everybody seems to be an artist around here. But he asked me, I gotta sharpen my pencil again. I'm burning through this colored pencil. It's like it was a brand new one when I started, and it's like already down 3/4 of the way. See where I was. So I gotta like think about this gun. But anyway, Travis asked me Like in an earlier video I did, I think especially when I started painting some of the movie stuff again, I said something like, you know, I kind of would rather treat it more like being a fine artist than a commercial artist. And he asked me about like what I meant by that, and I think he's gonna actually be a little bit disappointed at the answer, because I didn't really mean it like I think the way a lot of people do, where they're like, oh, there's a difference between fine art and commercial art, you know, and here's the difference, or here's what it is, and then they have like their reasons that sort of justify it. I don't really see any difference between any of it, really. You know, I mean, some people go, well, you know, it's your commercial art's for money and fine art's for, you know. But that's not really true, because, you know, if you're hanging in a gallery, you're painting for money. I don't know. I don't really discriminate against art, I guess. I mean, I'm open to whatever. And if, like, somebody can make it work and I like it, you know. I mean, I do like some abstract work, or a lot of it really, but I'm not a super like nutcase fan that's gonna like go crazy over it, you know. It's like I appreciate Jackson Pollock's work, for example, but I don't know, to me, like, to go, oh, that's art, you know. I remember I was painting houses for a lady who, and she had all kinds of art in her house, and it was all a bunch of abstract type stuff, and she started talking art with me, and I don't know if I told her that I was an artist or not. I don't think I did, because I didn't actually like her much, but you know, she kept saying that like anything that was like realism or whatever, it's just like, it's, oh, that's too easy, you know, too obvious is what she kept saying. And I was just like, it's just so ridiculous, you know, to be like, oh, this is better than this in art, because it's like, it's just your preference, you know. But anyway, I don't really, you know, I've had friends who are like that, like, I hate, you know, modern art and stuff like that, and I don't look at it that way. I think it's interesting, and, you know, really and truly, you know, like, when I go to a hotel, do I want, you know, I don't know, a fantasy painting with a dragon hanging on the wall when I'm trying to sleep? I don't know. Maybe not, you know. Everybody's got different taste. And, I don't know, I appreciate all art. But, what I was saying, though, and this is that gun, so it's kind of a, it's just a hard thing to figure out where it all is. Kind of a lot of detail there. But what I was talking about, kind of when I made the comment, was when I said, like, more, I just meant I wanted to paint a little bit more like a fine artist paints, or what I consider a fine artist, which would be like a guy in a gallery. And what I meant by that was, like, you know, a guy in a gallery kind of paints what he kind of comes up with. You know, he figures out what to paint, and then he paints it, and then he tries to sell it. And at the time I said that too, you gotta kind of take that into context, because I was working and trying to do the videos at night and stuff, and paint at night. And this, and also, and I remember, like, really specifically, because, like, all last year I had a lot of jobs that were very much. They were very much, well, I mean, you know, it's like I get commissions. Like, I mean, a lot of, like, last year, for some reason, I got a lot of just sort of illustration jobs. And I took a lot of them because I was trying to make extra money on my painting job. And I was having a really hard time getting my 40 hours in. And so I'd take them. But then, you know, they didn't really have, a lot of them didn't have anything to do with what, like, I'm kind of known for painting on the web, you know, like the movie art type stuff. You know, they weren't that kind of stuff. They were like, this one was like a game, and then there was, you know, like a board game, and then there was just a bunch of other just random stupid things that nobody really would give a shit about if I put them up on my site, even. You know what I mean? And a lot of them I just didn't, because I didn't really care for how they turned out. And that was kind of like my complaint, was it's like, you know, I wasn't even getting paid that great for them. I kind of, you know, a lot of these people would find me, and they'd kind of look at my commission price, and they'd be like, great, this guy's super cheap, you know. And we're going to get him to draw, you know, whatever, my board game, that's for, say, for example. Hopefully the guy who I did that for isn't listening. I don't know where that's going to hit. Just trying to kind of get some straight lines in here. But they're like, yeah, great, he's do my freaking board game that, you know, isn't really going to do anything for me. You know, it's like, yeah, I did a board game, but it's not even, you know, it's not like it's in Toys R Us, and even if it was, is anybody even going to realize that I drew any of that stuff? And, you know what I mean? And I also, I can't make prints of anything I did there. And it's, so it's like, even though, it's just the money. To me, like, when I thought about it later, I'm like, the money just isn't worth it. Because, you know, a lot of, I mean, I feel like I kind of sell my stuff semi-cheap. And a lot of times, you know, the reason I'm doing that, or the reason it works, let's say, it's not the reason I'm doing it, is because I can make up that money on the prints later. You know what I mean? You sell 10 prints for $10, you know, you're throwing $100 onto a piece. So if you sell it for whatever, $150, you know, you're already up to, you know, $250 or whatever, and that just goes on from there, you know, over the lifetime of a piece. You know, some of my small sketch cards are worth, you know, I mean, I don't know, I don't want to be all braggy, but you know what I mean, they're up there because I've sold a lot of prints of them. And that's kind of the way I, you know, what I meant by that. I wasn't really kind of trying to be elitist and be, you know, I'm a fine artist. I just meant, like, I want to paint stuff that I think that will sell, like on eBay and to whoever, like private clients, and will also sell as prints, and not be so much of a, you know, like gun for hire, where you know, we'll paint whatever it is, you know. That's something, you know, I've always had a trouble with, like when I see these guys with like sketch cards. I've never worked on a set of sketch cards yet. And I don't know if that bites me in the ass or not, but, you know, it's like, you get on these sets, and, I mean, unless you're on the Star Wars set or something, you know, I've seen the guys trying to sell the return cards on eBay for, you know, a couple $100, and they can't get it, because it's a picture of, you know, I don't know, somebody from Ghost Whisperer or something, you know what I mean, just something that nobody wants. And maybe somebody wants a Ghost Whisperer card. If you do, I'm not trying to insult you, but, you know, and then it's just like you've worked all that time on the cards, and you're not even getting anything for it, you know. Well, you're getting your whatever the heck they pay for those dang things, like $1 a piece or something. So, that's kind of what I'm talking about. I mean, I'm not talking specifically about sketch cards. Sketch cards is this one thing that I know doesn't pay much. So I'm just using it as an example. And, you know, it's kind of the same thing. I mean, it's just like, you know, people want what they want. I've kind of made a mistake at times, I think, you know, by getting off on into like, kind of esoteric type things, like, or not that, but I mean just into stuff that maybe the market just isn't, you know, as into as I am, you know. I'm thinking of, like, even though I think you could make a comic book work, I mean, I'm thinking about the comic book a little bit, because, you know, it's you know, once you start drawing pages, your art kind of quits being art, and it becomes kind of like in service to the story. So I could You know, like, I always have a harder time selling that kind of stuff. Even though, I mean, you know, some of my comic book stuff, like the Jack the Giant Killer stuff, did sell. But I think it's kind of just because it's like that I'd sell this other stuff all the time, you know. There's a lot of the same people bought that stuff, too, so. And I don't know. I don't have any time now, but I would still like to try to do some kind of illustrated book type stuff. I've had some ideas, but, you know, right now, man, it's like I just got to really concentrate on, you know, illustrating and making money, selling stuff, keeping everything rolling, and all that. So I hope that answers your question, Travis. I'll put your link in the show notes, too. Everybody should go check his stuff out. I'm sure... I'm just trying to think, like... Because I know I've seen your stuff on Facebook. I'm just trying to think, like... You know, I hope I'm not talking out of turn or something. Like, by trying to send you some traffic or whatever. Was that it for today? I don't know if that was a good video or not. That was kind of short, and I feel like I was almost too planned. Because I just, I knew what I wanted, what I had to talk about, so I just, you know, went from topic to topic. And I also kind of feel like I did kind of a boring part of this drawing, too. You know? So I guess I am going to call it good. Thanks a lot, you guys, for everything. And, thanks for, thanks to everybody who's buying my stuff. Thanks to the lady who bought the Wonder Woman piece I had up on eBay today. Things going out later today. I've got like a good system going now with my wife where she packages the stuff for me. And I make it. And so she's on it, man. It's like as soon as something goes sells off eBay, she is putting it in the envelope and going to the post office with it. So that's really cool because I've always kind of had a tough time of being like on it, you know, as far as that goes. And also that Robin Hood piece is available as a print in my store. The Boba Fett piece, which, where is that? Oh, it's actually, yeah, I forgot. It's out in the shed because I sprayed it. I can't show it to you, but that one's done. And that was a commission that's going to be sent out. And that one is going to be available as a print, too, as soon as I get it up in my my store and on my site and all that kind of stuff. So, thanks a lot, guys. Take care, and I'll see you tomorrow.